get into that. I think I'll play one more game of this, and we'll move on to hockey. Get a little Matt Meyer in. I suppose you could also drop me a message. Well, no, you know, I was going to say you could drop me a message on the Xbox, but don't do that. Because that gets flooded, and I frankly, you know, I've got 50-some messages sitting there right now that I haven't read, so you're probably best sending me, just send me, message me on YouTube. What do I do for a living? I work with seniors, I work for Volunteers of America, which may be worth doing a charity event, for themselves at some point, because I know they definitely would like it. But yeah, I work for Volunteers of America. I'm a program manager of an adult day program. So basically, seniors age 55 and older, who are fairly frail and have a hard time getting around in their communities, will take a public. What do you want to call it? They call that metro mobility here in the Twin Cities, but they'll basically take a bus from their apartments or from their houses and spend the day doing activities with us. Get a hot lunch at noon, and we do some community outings, do some fun stuff in the community when we can. Used to take them to Twins games back at the Dome, but we can't seem to either A, afford it, or B, get decent seats at Target Field now, so that's kind of out of the question, but at this point, but try to do some fun things with them and have a good time. So that's fun, don't get me wrong. I mean, I like doing that a lot, but doing this stuff is pretty much more of a passion of mine. Dealing with all this video stuff, doing website work, that kind of stuff is much more, I could sit here and do this all day. So anyway, that's just kind of my passion. You're talking about an age limit. Are you talking about for the site that I'm starting an age limit for it? Because no, I don't really see where that would come in. You know, we're not going to have like a contract on it or anything like that. It's just going to be, you know, a directory of sorts. So I should do a fundraiser to take them to Twins game. Yeah, that'd be fun. You know, it's funny because you know, if you watch the All Star game time, or the Home Run Derby doll, Volunteers of America is involved in a lot of that. They have what they call the action team. As a matter of fact, put the show in, start playing the show, you'll see Volunteers of America advertising, and that thing that says action team on the fences, that's a Volunteer of America program in conjunction with Major League Baseball. And basically, it's a thing to like get teens involved in working with seniors or working in their community. So back, oh, I don't remember what year it was. 2 years ago, maybe three. I think 2 years ago, they came and filmed some stuff for that at one of our locations here in the Twin Cities, and they had Maurer and Nick Punto show up and play Wii Baseball with the seniors. So here they were helping him, you know, to swing the bat and pitch all that using the Wii controls. And so they took pictures of the papers, and it actually got on the broadcast of the Home Run Derby and all that. So that was kind of cool. Got Joe to sign a baseball that's sitting right below my TV right now. So yeah, that was fun. But yeah, they're advertising that action team thing, and the Volunteers of America advertising is all over the show. I don't know why it's not in this game. What do we have? Two outs. Oh, he goes and steals third. If I would have known, I would have gone. Maurer is an awesome person. He's a little on the, he comes off as a little shy, and that's changed a little bit now that he's done some, you know, major commercials, all the, you know, Head and Shoulders stuff, and of course being the cover boy of the show, I think, has helped him out a little bit. But yeah, I mean, he's a, you know, he's a real all shucks kind of guy.
Oh, okay, we're jumping out of caps here now, so you can get, so I'll see it. Okay, I get it. What 2012 games am I most excited about? NHL's catching my eye. I want to see some of this stuff, like with their that they've done to the career mode, as far as like pretty much every highlight that you that happens in your career mode is accessible in this new. I'm forgetting the terminology they use now, but it's basically like a deal that stores all your highlights from every game, not just you know, a couple here and there. And I'm going to get thrown out at second base because I'm talking too much. Oh, Joe, pay attention. Anyway, I'm looking forward to NHL. I'm looking for We're Frozen. Great. Okay, well, I'll do something about that. Hang on a second. We're going to go black once again. But we will fix it. Yeah, no kidding. What happened to... Where did David Littman go in that whole process over there with the NHL series? Did he just disappear? I swear he came on stage at E3 or one of those events. But, you know, I said, what happened to David Littman? It's like, you know, he added up all this, and then did he take off for something else? Yeah, it probably was about the 10th time we froze, and I don't know what the deal was with that, or what the deal is with that. Okay, we're down 4-0. We get the bases loaded and nobody out. Joy, joy, joy. Okay. Go home with that one. No brainer. Nobody on again. Ah. Swung at a bad pitch there. Oh man, your dad works. So he works down in Fort Myers then? That's heaven for me, man. I'm obviously both a Twins and a Red Sox fan. Fort Myers is the place to be. Been down there a couple times. I guess I've actually seen more Red Sox spring training than I have Twins over the years. Why that is, I don't know exactly. Just kind of how it worked out. No, stay there. Stay there. He's going to gun you if you go to third. I have an authentic Schilling jersey with the 2004 World Series patch on it. Road gray. And then I've got a... If you see my Facebook page, I believe my profile picture is still me sitting in, above the monster this summer at Fenway, wearing my authentic white Ortiz jersey that also has a 2004 World Series patch on it. I, over the years, have been an avid jersey collector. Well, was that a home run? No. Double. Mostly hockey jerseys, but I don't have nearly as many now as I did. I mean, I had, oh boy, when I was collecting authentic jerseys I moved on to game-worn jerseys. Later on, but when I was collecting authentic jerseys, I had over 200 authentic NHL jerseys of all various teams. My Facebook, it's Matt Meyer, just like the hockey player. I named him after myself. It's Meyer. People want to add extra E's and S's in there. Oh, lay off of that. I wasn't even trying to swing at that. That's a foul ball.
Yeah, I did have a Gretzky jersey at one point. I had a white Kings, Stanley Cup era, Stanley Cup Finals era jersey, the one they lost to the Canadians. So it was a white Kings jersey. If you know anything about jersey material, it was the Ultrafill, the heavy duty stuff that they abandoned back in the mid 90s for the lighter air knit stuff. But it was the Ultrafill White Kings jersey, captain's patch obviously, and then Stanley Cup Finals patch on it. I have pictures of all these jerseys. I should make a YouTube video sometime and just like rifling through all the old pictures of the jerseys I've owned at some point in my life. So then I moved on from all those. My favorites were jerseys that had patches from special seasons or anniversary seasons, those kind of things. Those were always my favorite. So Stanley Cup Finals jerseys, All-Star Game patches, all that good stuff. Yeah, it's because Matt Meyer is M-Y-E-R, four letters. M-Y-E-R. And then then you should be able to find it. Wearing a Red Sox jersey, Red Sox hat. Have you seen the Showmum? The guy has all the Nike shoes in a warehouse. Huh, that's cool. Never been much of a shoe collector, but I can respect the art. So yeah, so then I moved on. I got into the world of game worn jerseys, specifically game worn hockey jerseys, and I burned through most of that collection too, because having young kids is expensive. Having a house is expensive, so sold a lot of them to kind of meet family needs, you should say. But I had a heck of a collection at one point. The most expensive jersey I ever had was a Mike Modano North Stars jersey that was worth probably about $2,500. I also had a Marion Gaborik Wild jersey, and it was before the Wild would really let any of their jerseys out. They're still pretty tight with their jerseys, but there weren't many Gaboriks out there, and I had one at one point. And man, I wish I had those still. I have no Wild. I've got a plenty of authentic Wild jerseys, but I have no Wild game worn jerseys left. And I have two my prized possession, my two game worn North Stars jerseys. Russ Courtnall and a Darian Hatcher rookie jersey. I don't add subs on Facebook. I have people adding me on Facebook all the time to play Madden Superstars and MLB Superstars, whatever you call those games. So, I'm not very picky on who I add. Just if you're worried about it, put a message in there saying YouTube sub or something like that. I'll definitely that ball got by me. I'll definitely add you. No worries. Bard is your cousin, as in Bard, the pitcher for Boston? Twins jerseys, I have two. I've got my Tomey
road gray, the new style road grays. And then I've got a I got like a blue home alternate that has no name on it. I had a Torrey Hunter jersey at one point, you know, white home pinstripe. That was cool. I'm getting some ads here right now on my phone, of course. Let me do this at bat first. I have not seen Tomy's 600th yet. I'm going to have to turn on the late sports centers to see it. I'm so bummed. I mean, I was at a couple games within the last couple weeks where he was within 2-3. I think he was at 597 at the time. And I was hoping he'd have a two-home run game or something and I'd see it. But I didn't. And so I'm bummed I wasn't watching tonight out yet, Tomy. I've wanted... okay, Andrew Stein, you were added. Connor, you're added. Jordan, you're added. On Facebook. Yeah, I had a two-homer tonight. Yeah, Torrey was the man on the Twins, man. It was a good run at center for a while. Kirby Puckett there, Torrey Hunter. Not so convinced that Ben Revere's the next or that Span's the next, but you never know. Oh, boy, I'm just not playing. I don't know if I was expected to get that or not, but I'm just not playing any D right now. And the ads keep on coming in. Brent and Sean, you're in. Yeah, you know, you certainly do get so much play on the 3,000th hit, and I think the problem with the homers is that people are just don't know what to do with those home run records after McGuire and Sosa and Bonds. But I mean, I can tell you, Jim Tomy, that guy is one natural lumberjack, man. That guy's all natural, and he's everything that's right about baseball. So, really, he probably should be higher up on that list if you take away the frauds. But I think that's the problem, is that you've got so much dilemma in people's mind on what to do with those home run records. Man, I'm just going to keep following pitches off to the right side here, apparently, until the guy gets picked at second. Oh, there we go. Innocent little hit to the right side, but that's an RBI. And now we'll try to steal a base. I don't know, oh boy, that was an awful jump. And I just ran right past the base again. Oh, yeah. I don't think I've successfully stolen one at all tonight. That's not the norm. I do not have season tickets to the Twins. I work with seniors. I don't have a whole lot of money to spend on season tickets. But I was actually in the club level the other night. I had tickets for the Red Sox game in the club level. Funny story, my stepdad, obviously knowing I'm a huge Red Sox fan, had a chance to buy some tickets, and he's like, "Hey, I picked you up tickets for the Red Sox." And I'm like, "Oh, great, you know, what do I owe you for that?" And he's like, "Oh, you know, they're 60 apiece, they're in the club level." I'm like, "Huh. Well, thanks for running that one by me." But I was glad I went. It was, that was something else, man. I tell you, that if kind of for, okay, what am I doing not going a third on that ball? I probably still could make it there. I tell you, I messed up on these controls. I'm playing the show in my mind here. And I'm still going back to the base, seriously. Okay, anyway.
But that club level is nice, and that ballpark is awesome. And it's just sweet. So, got a couple more Facebook deals coming in here. Robbie and Lane, you're good. All right. So, well, yeah, he made me pay for it. I mean, yeah, it's fine, whatever. I asked a friend of mine who's a little bit better off than I am if he wanted in, and so one ticket was taken care of, and it was, you know, it was an experience sitting at club level, and basically felt like you were there, like away from the crowd. It was amazing, you know, people opening glass doors for you. And best part of it is I looked over my left shoulder at one point, and there is sitting Kent Herbeck, you know, former first baseman, the Twins. Just so happened to be, you know, my idol all those years growing up. And, you know, his face is plastered all over the walls there, especially in that club level. Heck, the bar downstairs is named Herbeck's. But there he is sitting there, you know, with his wife. His kids are down a row in front of him eating peanuts, and just an everyday guy. So it's kind of cool. He actually does an outdoorsman type show here in town. So it was kind of cool to be brushing shoulders with guys like that. Oh man, I saw a fastball and I'm like, I need to hit a home run here. Ah, we're just not going to get one here, are we? Not going to get one. I think that's going to be the last game for Joe. We'll move on to something. Yeah, I actually have a ball signed by Herbeck, so I didn't really feel the need to ask for another. I got one back in the day. I think he had retired at that point. But, somebody asking about the Delmon Young thing again? Oh, yeah. Boy, I mean, they summed it up pretty well on sports radio here today. It's like, you know, that has to be considered a failed trade. You know, trading Garza and Bartlett for him. And then, you know, I mean, last year was admittedly pretty good. But, I mean, the power for Delmon Young had just fallen off the table. And it wasn't like he was hitting for average either. And he is a straight-out liability in the outfield. He so often gets turned the wrong way on a fly ball. It's scary. So, you know, it was to the point where you've got to take care of Kadire. You have to take care of Kubel. And you know, if you're going to lose any of these guys, you want to get something for them. So, I think it was the right move. I don't know how I feel about trading him within the division, but I mean, you know, let's face it, they're toast, they're out of it. So that's pretty much how I feel about that. Hey, FMF25, I was at a Phillies Twins game last year. Went out to D.C. for a week, and then I went. So I saw Strasburg pitch in D.C. I saw a game in Baltimore, and then I took a megabus from D.C. to Philly just to catch the Father's Day game last year when Pavano beat the Phillies. And then took the bus back right after the game. So it was quite an experience. Your ballpark's awesome. I got a bad sunburn, though. Sitting right out in the sun on the left, on the first base side there. But, yeah, there is a YouTube page for Not As Fan as well. It's just an extension of mine. So if you do, like, youtube.com/NotAsFan, that's there, too. But you were at that game, too, there, FMF? Yeah, it was a fun game. I mean, it was a... I had a good time because the usher, you know, I sat probably like 16 rows up from first base, and the usher in my row was just awesome. I mean, he sat there and talked to me all during batting practice, and he came around once in a while to talk. We just BS the whole game about baseball, and you know, he talked about Target Field and was talking about my experiences there. But the ballpark's awesome. And I had a good time out there, so I mean, it was everything about it was top notch. I'd go back in a heartbeat. Third baseline, 14th row. Yeah, you sound like you were just about the opposite of what I was. I got mine on StubHub. Same with DC. I had a front row seat, right down first baseline. You know, like kind of out to the outfield though, but front row seat where the seats jut out there at Nats Park. And so Strasburg warms up and he walks like 5 feet in front of me coming out into the dugout from his warm-up. So I'm sitting on this menu, but I think we will save out of this and move on to some hockey. StubHub is awesome. That's how I got my tickets for the at Fenway this year. That's how I got all my tickets out east last year. So,
yeah, StubHub is definitely nice. All right. Throw hockey in here. So we're going to do a little Matt Meyer, probably just a game, and then we'll move on to, we'll get Big Man in also, and then I probably crash, so, flipping through some game boxes here. So yeah, so I think I mentioned I'm writing reviews now. They asked me to write sports reviews for Machinima. And I was actually approached by Constant, the guy who does all the on-air stuff, you know, for Machinima Sports. And he asked me if I would be interested, and so he hooked me up with the editorial team, and they're like, well, you know, just send us a sample. So I basically just, like, wrote up a mock draft of a review of NCAA 12. And they liked it, and they... offered me to freelance, basically, and said, well, we already edited up your copy, we'll just send it back for a second look. So I made some changes, sent it back, and I've got a review up on Machinima's Inside Gaming already. So the best part about all that is that they've asked me to do Madden, and probably NHL as well. You know, I don't know, as far as I'm concerned, they can you know, I'll do all the sports titles that they want me to do. And so I'm basically on their list to receive an advanced copy of Madden so that I can do a review. So for the first time in my life, I'll be VIP on the Madden list. So I'm looking forward to that. Doing some more confirms here while I'm waiting for a load. Screen to go. Finally we go here. Looks like we're not frozen yet, so that's a bonus. Although I shouldn't talk too soon. All right, Here we go. Add a few more. I'm sure I did get your request. I don't know, I've just been... Yeah, my iPhone's been blowing up with requests here. Avery went to jail for pushing a cop. Was this something recent? Can I not play my next game here or what? What's the deal? Coach is making some changes, of course. I think I saw this the last time around. Must just not have saved. They're putting me down to the third line, I think they said. Yep. Alright, already. Get me out of here. Let's play this next game. Looks like we got the Canadians next. Down to the third line, boo. So how long have we been doing this stream now? Are we going on 2 hours, a little over 2 hours? Yeah, they demote you for playing well. Although this my last game was not very good, but yeah, they demote you all the time here after good games. Oh, nice pass. Come on, put it in. My guy still gets knocked all over the ice a lot. Oh, yeah, that was a nice pass. Almost 2.5 hours, yeah. That sounds right. NHL 11 has been a good game. Okay, I seriously have to pay more attention to what I'm doing here now. You know, I don't care. Whatever line they put me on, I do pretty well on this line anyway. Seemed like some of my better games were down on this line. And it doesn't cut your playing time because they just play the third line all the time instead of the second or first or whatever. Oh. Almost too close for a shot there. So I fought last time out. Yeah, we'll definitely do any SHL team in 12. I really like doing that. I kind of regret not doing as much in 11 here, although it seemed like every time I go on, nobody else was on. It just, you know, we kept missing each other for playing games, and I haven't really made an attempt lately, so would like to do more of that, though. It's always fun to play those games. Oh, bad passes on my part. Oh, are you serious? Wow. That was a strange goal. What the heck happened there? was a tip, but how did the puck come out so violently out the other way? Whatever. Strange goal. How bad are we lagging really bad right now? Are we due for another freeze? If I could adjust the settings on the fly, I definitely would. Nope, that pass isn't going to get to me. We need a turnover here. Good forecheck. Probably calling for me off the ice here. Nope, not quite yet. Wow. Okay. Oh, that's a post? That was bizarre, too. Puck is just bouncing everywhere. Got a power play coming. All right, look at some comments here. No leg for you. Okay, well, that's good. Yeah, Ultimate Team as well. Obviously, I like that aspect, playing Ultimate Team in Madden. For some reason, I don't know why I haven't done as much Ultimate Team in NHL. I got into it and then kind of stalled. And something about the system just doesn't seem quite as intuitive as the Madden one. So, but I'm sure I'll be checking that out. Oh boy, Hemsky just got railed there. Dacked right off the face off there. Why don't I do Ultimate Team now, like as in right now during this stream? Because that's a possibility. I don't even know what my team looks like at the moment. Get in there. Yeah, okay. We'll do Hockey Ultimate Team right after this game. Get a little hut in. Oh, trying to get a tip in front. Okay, we got a goal. I have no clue if I got an assist on there, and if I did, it was because it hit me in the breezers. Gagne, I believe. Nice little move. I didn't do anything other than have the puck hit me earlier in that shift, so let's see. Oh yeah, got the assist. I got the first assist even. Not bad. I will take that. So I play, I don't go to the bench. I mean, I go to the bench, but I don't sit on the bench. I play the other wingers that come out. Keeps me from, frankly, I play these games late at night, and if I sit on the bench, I guarantee you I will fall asleep. And that's not good, because then I start getting out of position when I come back out on the ice, and nothing works out well. Oh, nice hit there. If I can't get on the score sheet first two periods, I will definitely be looking to fight again. Penalty coming up. Got another power play coming into the second period.
So has anyone? I guess I started this stream about when it was about to come up. But has anyone watched the part one of that 2-hour live stream piece that I put up tonight? Did that go up okay? Does anyone know? Did anybody see it? Yep. Okay. All right. I haven't had a chance to favorite it or anything, or you know, make it the first video on the channel or anything. So I just hadn't even, you know, I tend to do quality check when things go on there. I don't expect you to sit there for two. Well, I don't. Maybe I do expect you to sit there for 2 hours if you've been here with 2.5 with me tonight. But yeah, some of you saw it live. Some of you might have missed it. So I got some complaints about the quality, you know, that one I threw up for the hour of Joe Broadway. But, I mean, you know, whatever. Some people just don't get it. For some reason, they would like less videos. I don't know. And then what do I hear complaints about all day? Do this video, do that video. So, I mean, I would assume more is better. Even if some of it's going to be streaming in lower quality, I would think people would want to check out what they might not have been able to be a part of live. So, you know, that's my reasoning for putting it up, but to each their own, I guess. All right, let's get a goal here. Get me another assist. Oh, I'll put that in. Meanwhile, I'm off in the corner here. Pass. Oh, way too late. Oh, I'll get a tip. Take it out of there. Come on. Oh, bad pass. I wanted to go around the boards with that. Well, we had some puck possession in that power play, but nothing to speak of goal-wise. Oh, there's one. Yeah. Yeah, everything in HD. I mean, you know, and I understand that on something you're... Oh, why did I upload the... Yeah, the Joe Broadway stuff that's up again, I mean, I know it looks redundant, but what I've done is I've submitted it to Machinima Sports is all I did. You know, I do the series in advance. You know, Joe Broadway at first was just on Machinima Sports. And then because it was taking a long time for them to put things up and people, you know, continued to want episodes, I started putting them on my channel beforehand. You know, this goes back to the 2K days even. And so, but I just thought that, you know, because Joe Broadway had been such a big part of, you know, the early times of Machinima Sports, that it'd be good to get the reboot series on there as well, the show series. So that's why that's starting over, and then I put it on my page because obviously I'd like people to, you know, give it some hits. So that's why I looks like a repost, I guess, you know, but it's new as in the fact that it's new to Machinima Sports, so I'd appreciate people giving it a hit now or then. Goal! There we go. All right, been waiting a while for that one. Holy crappy thing is that won't be on the highlight reel. Not in HD anyway. Does my wife watch my videos? You know, she's really supportive of all this.
But, you know, she doesn't really, you know, religiously watch, like, each video. She likes watching, you know, like, if I get featured on replay on Machinima Sports or something like that. She likes watching that, you know, with constant and everything, and I think she gets a kick out of reading comments and all that stuff. And for some reason, she got hooked on the live stream this weekend. And so now, tonight even, oh, they did not score there. Now, even tonight, she's hooked on reading all your comments and all that stuff. Now she's gone upstairs, like, you know, quite a while ago. But yeah, she's how did I miss that pass? And then how'd they miss the icing? Some sloppy play on both sides there. Come on, get that one. Rebound, please. That would have been a nice goal to have captured in HD. Now that we're talking about being HD snobs here, would have been a nice one for the series because people want another video from this thing. But really, this series and the Big Man series are advancing way too slowly. Now, is she hot for Constant? Yeah, there may be some truth to that. I don't know. I had her do an intro once. If you watched on Machinima Sports when I did broke the stick there. I went out of play. When she did an intro to one of my videos, I believe it was the Ask Not As Fan series, and it was probably, I think I've only done two episodes of Ask Not As Fan. So it would have been the second episode of Ask Not As Fan, and it's not under my, you know, it's not under my gamer tag or gamer tag. It's getting late. It's not under my YouTube channel. It's a Machinima Sports video that I posted. So if you look up Ask Not As Fan episode 2, she did the intro for that one. I think my kids are in there also later on. Okay. Supposed to go to the bench, but I'd like to score a goal first. Oh! You're kidding me. I'm going to have one of my best games here, and this is going to go unreported. Look at that. Oh, got a backhander around his pad. Nice.
Can we repost stuff on the new website?
I don't see why not. I mean, I think I don't know exactly how I want to do that. You know, like I've had a blog site before where I would if I had a YouTube video go up, I would put it in
copy the code and paste it to the blog. So I mean, I envision some of that, but you know, I don't know necessarily that each one of us would have 20 videos embedded on the actual site, or if we would just link to our YouTube channels. You know, I kind of plan on how I envision that looking. But I mean, when you're talking reposting, you mean like actually uploading to that website? Because I don't really plan on having it, you know, store a whole lot of file storage as far as uploading videos to it. Because I don't really want to get in any competition and being, you know, like another Machinima Sports or whatever. I kind of want to highlight our videos that are on there on Machinima Sports.
Oh, and if you have no idea what I'm talking about right now, I purchased a domain name and website, you know, web hosting, all the whole deal for sportsgaminguniverse.com. So I own that site right now. I went through Yahoo. I've used Yahoo before for websites, both for work and for various projects that I've worked on. And if you sign up for a year at a time, you'll get the first 3 months for like $7 a month. And then it becomes $10, $11 a month after that. So
all told, for like a year's worth of not only them, you know, registering your domain, but hosting your site and the whole nine yards, it's like $115 for a year.
How much did I spend on Ultimate Team?
More than I care to have spent on it. Let's put it that way. As the series went on, I didn't have to, because I mean, I learned how to do collections, and you know, things changed there. But before I got a hold of, you know, before I got the hang of it, boy, let's just say I put a couple prepaid Xbox Live cards into it, the $50 variety. So they not only have me on the hook for the game, but then some. So I mean, they talking about casinos earlier. They should comp me 12 for what I put into Madden Ultimate Team this year. So, but it was fun. It was a very addicting mode. I think I played that more than any mode of any game in recent years. And that's saying quite a bit, you know, as much as I like the NHL series and all this other stuff.
Yeah, oh, so you found the video with the Astonis fan video? Yeah.
So if you are a if you are a YouTuber who does sports videos, drop me a line on YouTube, because I'm going to kind of start compiling a list for the sportsgaminguniverse.com. I'm just like cherry picking here, aren't I? It's kind of early to be doing this. Thinking hat trick, though. Oh, this was a good game. This would have been one to have on the series for sure. See, now if this were NHL 12, we'd have that system where you could have all the replays at your fingertips, and it'd be easy for me to go back and get them after a game.
Oh. Oh, I've got Penner on the ice now. It's not even me. Go back to the bench. I want my guy out there. All right, here we go. Here's a chance. Oh. Come on. Hat trick chance. Let's go. Game's pretty well in hand here. 4-1. I doubt they're going to pull their goalie at 4-1. 3-1, yeah, they would have. Easiest way to get the hat trick is empty netter, of course. Ah. Why did they let him walk in right up the slot there, and why did I give him that? That's a gift goal. Yeah, I'll do Hockey Ultimate Team after this. Yeah, the website is under construction. I haven't had a whole lot of time to do anything with it yet. I'll be able to look at your comments a little closer as soon as this game ends here. Right now, I just got to make sure I don't have a meltdown. Oh, yeah. Oh, how do you miss the empty net? Okay, there we go. Secure the win there. Yeah, I can tell you the
I can tell you the quick story of how I got the... Well, I guess I'm going to be here a while. I can tell you the story about how I got the name Nada's Fan. My brother-in-law played for 10 years plus in a band called the Nadas. They all met in, well, Ames, Iowa, I guess, when they were all at Iowa State. And they're to this day a fairly popular band in the Des Moines, Iowa area. Oh, nice pass, but oh, he's not going to bury that. The Nadas, yeah, so my brother-in-law played in this band for over 10 years. He no longer does, but the band continues to play and tour around. So I did some website work for them back in their earlier days and went by the name Nadas Fan in a lot of the
chat rooms or forums, whatever you want to call that, and that
kind of stuck with me as I went to various online forums on the internet and everything. I just kind of took that name,
and it stuck with me. So that's where Nadas Fan comes from. It's from the band the Nadas, and if you go to thenadas.com, you can check them out. There you go, first star, 2 goals and an assist. And man, oh man, that would have been a good game for the series, like I said before. So, now watch, they'll probably put me down to the checking line after 2 goals and an assist. Got some decent XP in that game. Hamsky's going to be out a while. Yeah, a hernia, huh? That's what happened to him. They're going to make some line changes. So what, do I go to first line now? Well, anyway, we'll jump into Hockey Ultimate Team in a second here. Take a look at that.
Dust that off, shall we say. I haven't touched that in a while. Of course, I forget where to save in here. Seriously. There it is. The brain is starting to turn a little mushy at this point. All right, that's saved. Reset the rosters to whatever. Okay. So, my ultimate team, overall, 86 offense, 85 defense, 81 goalie. And that darn salary cap is what gets me every time. I think that's is part of my difficulty in this, is the salary cap. So, is there something you want to see specifically with this before I play a game? You want to see, like, roster?
lineup.
Okay. Okay, so top lined is Raymond, Jeff Carter, and Erat. Cleary, Wilson, Nystrom on the second line. Some of these guys I had to put in just because of cap reasons. I had a better lineup at one point. I think I learned a lesson too late on some of this. Annis is a pretty good player for me here. He's pretty maxed out. Sortini, who's also on my B-Pro team with Edmonton, obviously. Tarnowski. Like I said, a couple of these guys I had to throw in either because of contract or because of most likely because of salary cap. I had a more solid lineup at one point. Anyway, I think I learned from somebody not to... I forget what the rule is now. It's like you want to... something about when you apply their training and how it affects the salary cap. And if any of you play this a lot, maybe you can refresh me on that. But I know there's a way to go about it where you do the training at a certain time so that it doesn't affect the salary cap as much. So defense, Schubert and Letang, Schultz. I like this. I like my Schultz and Schultz pairing on the number 2D. Nick, the Wild, and you got the Capital Schultz as well. Then there's a third pair of defense. Goalies, Habib Bulin, bought him as a off the block for basically because he had quite a few games left on his contract, or because these guys can only that's the other difference is you lose these guys, you not only have to feed them contract cards, but the life of their overall contract, that's a big difference between Madden Ultimate Team and the Hockey Ultimate Team, is you actually lose these cards after a while. So just something about that is a little bit different. And then just like Madden, the chemistry on these kind of baffles me. I haven't taken the time to play around with what makes a good chemistry line, what doesn't. If I had more time to perfect and tweak, I'm sure I would do it, but I just really don't. So that's lineup. There's my shootout lineup. Let's see. You can add me on PS3, but I think both my PS3 and Xbox lists are full right now. Okay, you put a long contract, then train them so you get them cheaper. Is that how that works? Okay. Long contract, then train them. See, that's what I did. I think I trained them, and then I did contract. I did exactly the opposite, and I think I screwed myself over. So, good chemistry line equals same team or league. Okay, yeah, I kind of thought there was some of that, but, so... Head coach is some stiff. And as far as stadium, I don't know. I think I'm using like the International League stadium. Wild jerseys for uniforms. I had them. I bought those out just kind of for continuity's sake. I had some crazy uniforms going on for a while. The collection itself, I don't know. I haven't done much. Unlike Madden Ultimate Team, I have done like nothing in collections, so I don't even know, is there any reward for doing collections, or is this just a place to store your cards? Basically, it's kind of what I got out of it. So yeah, my arenas, medium North American, I guess is what I'm using right now. See a
VA Baseball. Thanks for hanging out for a while. Do I want you to sell you some cards? Sell me some cards? Yeah, sure. But I don't really know what I have for. I have 381 EA pucks right now, so I don't think that's going to buy me a whole lot of anything. So, anyway, I suppose we're kind of getting towards the end of the cycle of this game, and we'll be jumping into 12 soon. So, can I post the rest of the stream from tonight? Yeah, sure. I'll try to post all this. It might be a little hard for people to watch with all the restarts we've had tonight, but I will see what I can do. So, see you, those of you who are taking off. Thanks for hanging out. These live streams are awesome. I'm glad you think so. Thanks for watching. Am I tired? Yeah, I'm a little tired. Like I said, this is kind of my wheelhouse, you know, nighttime here, so I'd rather be doing this than sleeping. Midnight Lovin', what's going on? Alright, I'm going to play a game here. What's my favorite type of salad? Taco salad. Is there any doubt? Elephantillion 4121. Can I game with you, please? What'd you have in mind? Add you an Xbox. Yeah, I'm going to have to clear some space. I already did say your name. I just think I butchered it. Panthers fan here to the end. You're the man.
What is it with my stream and people talking about tacos? I know that one was my fault. I brought that one up, but what's that up with? Is it the Spanish the whole not as fan thing? Or what is the deal with that?
Yeah, I hear you, Garito 16. She's sleeping already. So, Joe Broadway. We just did Joe Broadway. Oh, you want me to play me in the show?
I've never played anyone head-to-head in the show. As a matter of fact, I guess I've never played online in the show. There's a time for everything, but I think that's probably going to have to be a different time. We already did some 2K10 with the old school Joe Broadway, and so I don't know. The show takes a good amount of time. So why don't we play a game? Is anybody online that has a Ultimate Team on the 360? I don't know how the matchmaking works on this, but
you're on right now. You on for NHL? You mean? Because, yeah, I mean, I'd gladly play somebody in Ultimate Team if somebody's accessible at the moment. Send me a request or however it works.
I've only played random online games. I've never, done matchmaking or whatever it is you do. Failed miserably in tournaments before.
All right, sounds good, Coop 15. Your birthday is tomorrow? How old will you be tomorrow? Yeah, it's cool. Do the update, that's fine. It's 1:25 for you, it's 12:25 for me. Can I check my inbox on my Xbox? Colin, 92441.
When's your birthday, Hurricane? $5.25. Oh. $6.25? Ooh. Please tell me you don't have to go to work soon. September 5th. Okay, that's coming up. I'm sure we could figure something out. England, okay. Thanksgiving birthday. My birthday is exactly a week before Halloween. Oh, YouTube inbox. Yeah, I'll check that. I'm not gonna check that right now, but yeah, definitely. We'll check that out. Yeah, I'm waiting to play this Hockey Ultimate Team game. The next Joe Broadway episode on YouTube.
Oh, if you watch two, you know, three through five or six are on my channel. If you go to my channel and click on playlists and go to the Joe Broadway Road of the Show, I think there's a playlist for it there. I submitted those to Machinima Sports just recently, so they're on episode two, but I'm actually through five or six. So if you want to see that, but there is a, but yeah. So I think I'm on, like, I think the next one to come out will be seven, and that'll be probably pretty soon. I don't know. I guess that's my answer to most. When people ask when whatever's going to be up pretty soon, as soon as I can get to it. I got to play all those games before I can have video to edit, so. And when I'm doing a stream here, then that's going to slow things down even more so. But this is fun. So. How we doing, Coop 15? Are you still updating?
Yeah, I suppose you could count the stream as an episode, especially since he got traded during the stream.
You have a Jake Homerman? Yeah, put him up. I mean, I don't have a copyright on my names or anything like that. I've seen other Joe Broadways and
things like that before. Oh, excuse me.
All right, so Coop 15, are you able to send... What is your gamer tag, by the way? Just so I know when it comes through. And are you able to send a request for a game? Yeah, no problem, Midnight Lovin'. Go for it. Just, yeah, I don't know. If anybody gives you crap, tell them that, whatever. Tell them to watch the stream and fast forward to hour three and, okay, you're green's free to delete. Okay. Yeah, I still play Madden Ultimate Team. I collect cards a lot more than I play games. But even that has slowed down. Not that there hasn't, you know, they're focusing on 12. They focused on getting that out the door, and you know, haven't. To their credit, they did specials, you know, right down to the end on card packs and all that kind of stuff. So I mean, they supported it really well. Could I send you a friend request? You know, I can. I can't. I'm not gonna do it right now. But you know, like I said, I've got to clear some room first. See what's on the store here while we're wait. Did you send a request? I didn't. I missed it. If you did, yeah, I don't have enough to buy a pack or anything. Dealing more with individual cards or whatever anyway. Ah, here we go. I will certainly try to send the invite.
See if I can figure out how to do it. Well, let's just put me into a random. It will, won't it? No, I don't want to search for an opponent. Cancel. How do you send an invite? Yeah, the interaction is definitely the best part of these live streams. It makes it fun. Hockey Hub. All right. So I'm assuming go out then. But can you do Ultimate Team from the whatever from the Hockey Hub, or how do I? I should know how to access that, but. Yeah, I don't know. They keep saying that XSplit beta is going to end soon. Rank match? Yeah, that's fine. Okay, where is it that you actually just... whatever. Alright. Cool. You're from Philly. I usually play with Mini on here. I don't get to play online all that much, but I take them anyway.
Yeah, I'll check out my YouTube inbox. Don't worry. I've been to Toronto once. Couple games at, well, it wasn't Rogers Center then, it was Skydome.
watched Skydome close once from the CN Tower. That was kind of cool. Whoa, Burnsy's flying out of the way there. He's a shark now, anyway. Ugh. So much for dumping the puck in. Didn't even get that far. Oh, Bruno, take the puck with you, buddy. Andrew Brunette, I'm going to miss him. My all-time favorite Wild player. Not even close. Ha! I shouldn't be, forcing the puck up with the goalie that way, but bad habits. Nope. Ah, did it again. Lots of Andreas. Oh, what, Cullen? Cal Clutterbuck. Oh, nice pass. Yeah, I work tomorrow. I used to live in White Bear Lake, like when I was back in elementary school. I moved out west suburbs, junior high school, out, you know, Plymouth, Wayzata. I went to Wayzata High School. I'm gonna get blown out here if I don't be careful. Why am I a Red Sox fan? I don't know. I just always have been for almost as long as I can remember. It all goes back to the 86 World Series. And yes, you know, the Bill Buckner, the curse, everything. And I just identified with that team and all that. And have been a fan at least from that point. So I've always been a dual, you know, Twins and Red Sox fan, though, and, you know, never one more than the other, really. You know, living here all my life, of course, and yeah, that's gonna be a penalty shot, eh? Maybe. No. So I've been out to Fenway three separate times in my life. Back in 91, when the year the Twins took the World Series, that was a bad giveaway. Saw a Twins Red Sox series right after the All-Star break that year, where the Twins just massacred the Red Sox 4 games straight. And so there was that. And back in 01, just a few months before September 11th, I guess I was out there in, well, was it April or May of 2001, in Boston, saw Yankees Red Sox at Fenway, and then 3 days later saw Yankees Red Sox at Yankee Stadium. So that was a heck of a trip.
And then again this year, so... Oh, yeah, you're just killing me here. As I tell stories, you're scoring goals. But anyway, So my Fenway trips, for some reason or another, are spaced out exactly 10 years from each other. So I guess I'll be back in 2021, if all goes well. You're just toying with me now. If I would just learn my lesson and cover pucks, I'd probably be okay.
Yeah, I'll try to read all the YouTube messages for sure. I check those on a regular basis. Oh, come on, Backstrom, seriously?
Of course, it wouldn't kill one of the defensemen to, like, you know, try to help. I was born in 76. I'll be 35 this year. Well, my defensemen are all standing around watching you, you know, whack at the puck there. I think they gave up after the second one.
Your mom was born in 79? Okay, I'm feeling old now.
And I feel like I'm chasing the puck a lot.
It's because I am. Schultz runs himself into the boards there.
Oh, Koivu just gets destroyed. Oh, rebound. Oh.
You look like Lemieux dangling out there. Come on, Colin, go, go, go. Oh, I thought that was my guy. Thought I had 2-on-1 and I had nobody. I think it's time for more dump and chase on my part here. Oh. Yeah, of course that was offsides. Oh, nice sliding play there. You anticipate my every move.
Including that one. Please.
Cam Barker. Nystrom. He's been pretty much a flop. Yeah, sure, let's go. He can't get his gloves off. Whew, lights out. Down on the scoreboard, down on the fight card. Not much hope. Oh. My defense is not even on the ice. So was Tomy 600, was it a tape measure shot, or did it just barely clear the fence, or... I'm envisioning it one of those that's like 20 rows back, because that's just the way he does things, but curious because I haven't seen it yet. I'm so pissed I missed that. See what live streaming has done to me? Alright guys, I'm thinking that after this game, I'm probably going to have to call this stream a night here, because... Well, number one, I need to get some sleep so I can work today. And number two, there's a couple things I want to do YouTube video related before I do go to sleep. So, a couple things I'd like to get done, hopefully. I mean, get a video done? Probably not. But either rendering some videos, moving some clips from my laptop to my Mac, rearranging some things, editing, whatever. It's all a process. And it's easier to do when you're awake. I think I majorly tripped you there. Has anybody been commenting during the stream so long that you've just forgotten totally what you said at the start? I feel like I'm about to start recycling stories. Okay, who are we voting for King of the Night on ESPN? I just got the text. Oh, CNanners just went live. Of course, I don't know how long ago that popped up. So there's always that after my stream. Yeah, like that backhand had any chance.
Yeah, no, I'm totally getting smoked in this game.
There is no... As Jacques Lemaire would say, there is no doubt.
Like, when I do random online games... I mean, I guess it probably tries to match skill or whatever, but... I usually, like, can at least stay in games.
But this is just... like, no contest. Oh, see, like, you even recovered on that. Oops. Yeah, that was a cheap shot. Daniel Breer. What was that? Slow motion shot. Oh, Bouchard. That had to have been another concussion. Set him out another year. Oh, and then I'm offside. I was offsides, wasn't I? Wow. Looked like offside to me. Oh, take the puck with you, Koivu. Wow.
Just wow. Yeah.
I'm hoping to fall down and one goes in accidentally here. But I'm not holding my breath. Oh, yes.
That 1-on-4 here? That's gonna work out.
Got the worst of that one. Oh, it's one guy got in the way. Seriously. Get some shots anyway. Not any of them good.
Rebound there, finally getting one. Jeez. Thank you.
Well, kind of too late to be getting a power play here and get anything out of it. Oh. Just punishing.
Hey.
It's been a few too many late nights lately between the 24-hour stream and couple other streams here. Everything else starting to get a little loopy here. This has been a lot of fun, though, guys. I enjoy doing these. It's definitely a plan I have to do quite often. Yeah, like some of you said, it's a great way to interact. You know, I can throw YouTube videos up there and you can comment, but you know, nothing beats the, you know, the real time aspect of this. Oh. Just walk through, my D. Oh, poor Havlat. Couldn't even get that to go. Good game. You thoroughly dominated my squad there.
No, you didn't. You didn't miss, big man. Okay, did I, what did I miss? What am I getting a little too old for? Oh, staying up all night? All-nighters? Yeah, you too, that was a great game. I, only wish I could have, matched your squad a little better. I merely provide a forum for you guys to all, show up and kick my ass in all these games, so. Read your message on Xbox Live. What's your tag on Xbox Live? FMF25. Is that the same? Yeah, it's cool. No, thanks for playing me here. Yeah, all-nighters? Yeah, well, I don't know. That's still kind of my thing. Oh, real tree. Okay. If I have a spot, I'll add you. No, I'm full. I gotta go through and clear some space. I don't know how the fairest way to do that is either. I always feel bad when I'm doing that. But, I'll figure something out. So, yeah, I'd like to add all you guys. I don't know. I've got to go through. I wish there was a way of finding out. I don't know. Is there a way to find out how long someone's been on your list? Because, I mean, if there are people that have been on there since, like, you know, years, they're probably people that I don't really deal with at this point, so probably added them for games at some point and just left them on there, but Unfortunately, I've never seen a way to sort it that way. Like, you know, how long they've been your friend or whatever, so. But, yeah, so I think, I know you wanted Big Man so bad, Jay Small. I think, that's actually what I do right now, is delete the people. Oh, Baseball, you're back, man. Can I respond to your YouTube message to let you know that I've read it? You mean like right now? I'll look at it. I'll get to it. Seriously, I'll read them all and get to them. So yeah, I was about to call it on this, but you know, I do kind of feel bad because Smalls did want to see Big Man. Let's see, this has been going 9 to... Are we going almost on 4 hours here? Are you kidding me? I'm going to stop the stream because I'm pretty sure that if I want to load this to YouTube later, I think 4 hours is pretty much the max on a YouTube video, is what I've heard anyway. But let me stop it. Bring it right back up as a new one. We'll throw in Big Man for a little bit, and then I'm going to call it quits. So, that's cool with everybody. Just hold tight. Yeah, my Xbox Live's blowing up here, apparently, so. So hang tight. This is going to go dead for a minute, and then come right back. Ten hours is on the max for YouTube. Is that confirmed? Does anybody know? Yeah? Okay. All right. Well, we'll stay here. I'll throw Big Man in. And
play that for a little bit. So seriously, I'm itching to see that Tomy homer. I'm about ready to pull that up on my iPhone. I've got the
MLB at Bat app
where you can actually watch games on there, and then, you know, of course, the highlights and everything. So I'm thinking about maybe when this loads, maybe I'll pull that up and take a look. So I hope you guys appreciate this. I was about to pull the plug, but I think I did say something about playing Big Man earlier. So like to get it in. Where is my at bat app? Here we go. A
little tired. No big deal. It was impressive. Was it a moonshot for 600?
Oh, that's the, you know, really, that's the only way for Jim to do it. That just makes so much sense if that's the case. Alright, I'm pulling this up. They've got there's a crew request. Alright, I'll check it out. Oh, I've been dying to play a crew game. I just, every time I go to do it, it seems like we can't connect. Okay, I'm watching $5.99 right now. That cleared the bullpen. That was not a bad shot. Oh, I'm wearing my Tomy jersey to work tomorrow. Have to do it. Headset for the PS3? I don't have one for the PS3. I don't think. Uh, Okay, so 599 was opposite field. He's got so... He's got such good power opposite field.
Where do I check... where do I check for your crew invite? Do I have to go to the section where the crew is?
Oh, so 600 was a three-run shot, huh? Oh, he put it same... Oh, wow. Oh, that was nice. Way to go, Jim. That was nice. He did it in a win, too. That's nice. It wasn't just a footnote, you know. He contributed to the win. That was nice.
Good for him, you know. That not a better guy.
Better players, but not a better guy in baseball than that guy. That's awesome. All right, putting that away.
Go to the pad thing, go to team up, then go to crew invites. Easy enough. Oh! I apparently have a few. You're the Mr. NBA 2K whatever, right?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Okay. Can you be in more than one of these at a time?
Oh, I gotta get out of my crew first.
I made a team, not as fan, but I could never connect to any games for whatever reason. I stalled out in the matchmaking screens. What are we... Why are we loading Big Mac? Okay. I just need to get myself out of this crew, I guess. A duo... Leave my crew. Self-explanatory. I'm the only member that's remaining anyway. What? Here. I'm going to name my buddy the successor here. Make him the GM. And I'm out. Okay. Let's try this again, shall we? What's 571 hours? Are you serious? There's a YouTube video that's 571 hours? And what the hell is it about? So are we all starting a crew here? Is that what we're doing? Because you can get your big man fixed by doing this.
That's who I use. As a matter of fact, here we go right now. Not that he's any good. No, wait a sec.
How did I go back to my team?
I'm confused. How did I go back to my team? It must not have worked right. Crew invitations. Well, now what's the deal? Okay, you're going to have to send me the crew invite again.
If you could do that, please. $571 of pictures? Seriously? Wow. Yeah, but how... I've got a headset on doing this. I'm not going to be able to hear you on that. Just tell me on here if you can.
What was it called again?
Yeah, go up to... Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it says I left it, I guess.
The gangsters crew. Somehow I accepted your invite, and but it showed me in my old crew. Okay. Yeah, kick me out and add me again. That'll work. Well, yeah, I'm assuming we all could play crew. There we go. Okay, I'm now a member. Yes, I'd like to use my MyPlayer. This is what I did last time. And it brought me back to my old squad. So you know what gives? It put me back on my old team.
Why? Because you just do that major play.
Why are you up at 1:30 in the morning, dude?